morning has a new beginning, a new blessing, a new hope, and a new learning. A pleasant morning to everyone gathered here. Let this new inception bring a smile to your face and happiness to your day. Adding more value to your day, we are here with yet another beneficial student webinar. One cannot change your destination overnight, but you can change your direction overnight. A teacher is the one who brings the best in student, one who changed lives with just right mix of chalk and challenges, whose noble profession shapes the character, caliber, and future of an individual. So it's my honor, more than a pleasure, to welcome our faculty coordinators, Dr. Shanti Ma'am, Mr. Sampath Kumar, Ms. Gayatri Ma'am, Ms. Niranjini Ma'am, Ms. Saranya Ma'am, for their devoted and tireless efforts in making the webinar happen. Now I call upon Ms. Saranya, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, ma'am.
On behalf of our management, our Principal Ma'am Dr. Sudha Mohan Ram, Sri Ishwar College of Engineering, our HOD Ma'am Dr. R. Shubha, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, our respected faculties and our beloved students, I welcome you all for the Student Webinar Series 2021. The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Every week, we are conducting Student Webinar Series 2021 on our emerging technologies, both technical and non-technical topics, with around 500 participants. We had a great involvement from our student speakers, volunteers, and faculty members. I feel extremely proud to start our webinar series with a fresh and energetic mood. It is a great honor for me to say that our students are growing more in all aspects, including their technical knowledge, passionate about their work, and also the way of doing their activities, and it should be recognized and appreciated. We hope that this series will be a great start for them, where they can showcase their interest, explore their ideas, and share their knowledge. This platform gives our students the opportunity to develop their leadership skills, to improve their work culture, and also helps them in to change the way of decision making in the right direction, in order to accomplish many things in this competitive environment. Before we would like to start our session, I once again thank you all your great support, and let us motivate our student friend to grow more at their higher levels during their career. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. It is a true pleasure to start off with today's webinar session on virtual control system using Git. The field of software engineering is a rapidly changing field. All applications and codes are always undergoing continuous development. One of the essential aspects of software engineering is version control. Today's embedded software development processes are complex, involving multiple designers, engineers, and developers. Without a version control system, it's challenging to work on the same source code at once. As the software we build grows bigger, more complex, and more versatile, the knowledge of version control and how to use it efficiently is one of the essential skills that any software developer needs to obtain and develop. Git version control is one of the most popular options. To know more about version control system using Git, I welcome student speaker Rakesh Roshan P from third year CSE to take over today's session. He is a quick learner and interested in exploring new innovative ideas in emerging technologies. He is also a good communicator, always involves him in resolving the tasks related to web technologies. He is passionate about knowing how the projects run in real time, and he contributes his own idea in GitHub through which he enlightens his knowledge level. His achievements are, now he got selected as campus ambassador at Internberg, an internship program. This internship program made him a good decision maker and best contributor towards his project. Now I hand over the session to Mr. Rakesh Roshan.
Thank you, Bhavya. I think I'm audible. Hello, everyone. I'm Rakesh Roshan. To start the webinar series, let me share the screen once again. Hello, everyone. Hello everyone, I am Rakesh Roshan. To start this webinar series,
and today's webinar topic is about version control system using Git. Without further delay, let's start our presentation. The evolution of Git has seen an incredible growth in the development of this software field. Many software tools have a limited lifespan. Despite all, the version control system Git is playing a major role and gigantic role in how to make our real-time projects more efficient and more interesting. More interestingly, big tech companies to startup companies make their software open source so that the developers around the world can make their project to a better version by contributing to the software. Contributions means like making their projects more advanced and more updations. To do this in more efficient way, let's start our session. In this session, we are going to see what is meant by Git, what is GitHub, few Linux commands, the pictorial representation of Git, then few GitHub commands and branch workflow, then how to do forking and contributions. Okay, let's see what's meant by Git and GitHub. First of all, Git is a version control system. Distributed version control system. Okay, let us take a scenario in which a company is creating a software. They are hosting their software in a platform called GitHub. This GitHub is a platform where we can host our software or any projects from any place, and the developers from all over the world can contribute to the software if the software is placed in public. If it is in private or any If it is placed in private, then only the colleague members or the team members inside the company can contribute to the software and to make it more advanced. Nowadays, big companies and big tech companies make their projects open source so that developers can contribute to the software. And this is how the GitHub and Git works together. Okay, let's see in more further. Few Linux basic commands. CD is mainly used for change directory, then to move your file from one place to another. So MD is used to see the content of the file. We use cat command. Then to see the working directory or where we are working, we can see public working directory as pwd. Then to clear all, we use clear command. Okay, next, let's see a small intro about Git. Git can be run in two different ways. One by using graphical user interface. One is GUI. It's also user friendly and handy to use, but mainly developers use CLI mode, command line mode, so because it has many features more than the graphical user interface process. Okay, how the GitHub works? We can work in GitHub one through local repository to remote repository or remote repository to local repository. Let us see more in detail by hands on. Okay, let's move on in hands on session. Okay, first let's create a folder name. Any folder name for this video, let's make a folder name sample. We have created a folder sample and we have created this. Now let's open Git Bash. Git Bash, the place where we place our command to do. Okay, first let's give the command git init. Git init means it's the command to create or initialize a .git file. .git file is used to make your projects tracking. Okay, let's move further. Let's see the status of our project, whether it's in what process. Let's say git status. In git status, it shows that there is nothing to do and nothing is happening in our project. So now let's move on to our folder and let's begin do some small coding. Okay, now I open my VS Code editor. Let's create a small sample web page, sample.html. okay, I have created a small web page. Okay, now let's, using boiler template, we create small web page and let's make its title as sample page. Okay, let's just give a hello world program, same as usual whenever a developer start doing their projects or start working from beginning. Okay, let's do hello world. Okay,
Now, let's save this file. Now, let's open our Git Bash account. Okay, now let's see what's our, how is our project, is how, what's happening in our project. To do this, let's do Git status to view the status of our file, what's going on. So, now we have created a HTML file and it's an untracked file. So, to do this, to track, and we need to make our project from untracked to tracking area, then tracking to staging area. We see in more detail about tracking in further. Okay, let's go Git track dot to make our project in track. Okay, now let's move on more. Git status, let's view this in Git status. Okay, it says that our file has been tracked and it's in the staging area. To make it commit, we need to do git commit minus m. Minus m is used to show that we are providing a small message that what we have done. Usually, whenever we commit, we need to give a small message what we have done in short and crisp word. To do this, we give created a sample web page. Created sample web page. Okay. Let's do this. It shows that you have committed MS. You have committed. To view what we have committed, let's give git log to see what all the commits we have made. At present, we give a commit. A username is Roshan and myself, and then on what date we have committed and the message what we have committed. Git sample web page. Okay. Let's see. Next way of how to create our remote repository to local repository. Okay, let's go to GitHub. One second. Let's go to GitHub. Okay. As usual, we need to create a new repository. Then give a name, any possible name which you like or any related name to our project. Let's give a name as test. Okay, we have test one. We have created a new repository named test one. We made it public. If we need to make it private or to work only with us, only work within private, and then we can change from private to public. As now, let's keep our project in public, and let's, as usual, create a repository. Okay. Now we have created our repository in our remote repository. Remote repository means the host where GitHub is that. Okay. Now we have created our remote repository. Same as usual, the same thing we should do. In this, we can do in two different ways. One, by using when we create, if we haven't created anything in our local repository, at that time we need to clone this repository. To do this, we can click here and clone our repository. Or else, if we have a project in our local repository, and we can add the existing project from our local repository to the remote repository. To do this, we can use these commands to do. Ensures easy, and we can do more in detail. Okay, let's make a repository from remote repository to local repository. Okay, let's create a new folder. Okay, let's create a new folder. Let it be named. And let's open our Git Bash. Now let's give Git clone. Git clone is a command which is used to clone our file from the remote desktop. Remote desktop means from GitHub. Now let's clone. We gave the HTTP that URL. Then we are cloning. As now we have cloned the website. And now the remote URL present in the website in the web is now present in our local repository. Now we are opening this. Now it says you have empty repository. Okay. Let's initialize it. Let's see the status of our file. Okay. It says there's nothing that to commit and nothing has been done in our project. Okay. Let's create a text document. We use touch command. Touch, then file one. .txt, any type of command, any type of file we can create. The person we created a text file, you can see here, and then we move inside and let's type anything. To do this, we use Vim. You can use Vim editor or any editor. Now, I use code, VS code to do code dot is used to, by default in code dot we have Vim editor. We can change it by using git config, which we'll be learning further. Let's now see what is happening. Okay. In text document, we are creating some hello all. Okay. Now let's save this. Let's open our git bash account. Git bash. Now let's see the status of our file. The images, same steps will be happen for every types of project and any type of project. To do this, we need to give git status. Every time we need to see our status, what's the, how is our file and what is happening in our file. Now it says that file.txt is being untracked. To make it track, we are giving git add dot to make track and making in the staging area. Staging area is the place where we need to commit. Okay, let's commit in it. Let's see the status once again. Okay, here it shows that file.txt has been committed now, has been in the staging area. To make in commit, let's give git commit minus m. The message we need to give is I have created a new text document. Created a new text document. Okay, let's go. Now it says that you have similar command. Sorry, one second. A small error. Okay, let's go. It shows that you have committed here. Now you have committed. This is the following steps to commit and do few things you see. Git commands to make our project tracking. Now, when we delete this, now let's once again run the bash command. So let's clear it to. Okay, now let's see the status of our file. So git stat is git status. You can see that we have modified our file text file. So now let's add that also. The staging area. It says that now let's see the status of our file. Okay. Now it's in the now the file is being modified. Okay. Let's commit this also. Whenever we make changes, we must commit so that we can have a snapshot of our commit. This snapshot means a small changes. Whenever we make changes, all the changes will be have a copy in our .git file. Okay. Let's give hello. It's just on this. Sorry, one second. We have committed a message. Now, by these two steps, we can do like this. Okay. The same thing what I told is in local repository. At first our project is in untrack. To make in track, we must initialize our project a .git file. Then we need to see the status of our file, git status. By this it shows that whether our project is in tracked or untracked, or it is in monitored by git.git files. To do this, we need to give git status. Then we need to change our file to the staging area, which means git add dot or same. If we have many number of files, we need to stage only single text doc, single document or any document, we need to give the specific name of it. Then we need to commit it. We will see push in detail. Now let's see the pictorial representation of Git. As I told earlier, that we create a repository in our local. In local, how it will be? First, the project. First, we create a folder, and then our project is in null. When we give git init, our project will be start tracking. That means from untracked, it will be going to staging area. To do this, we need to give git status. By giving git status, it shows that whether our project is in tracked or untracked. To make it more from untracked to track to the staging area. Staging area means the place where we need to commit our project. Okay. Then we can commit our project from untracked to staged or from unmodified to staged. Same in local and remote, both happens same similar to each other. Okay. If we are using Git for the first time, then we need to give few configurations that the username, then the email ID. To check that, we need to do this command. Okay, let's do in hands-on. Okay, let's see. Git config means global. Global means anyone can see that what we have done. Set global user dot name, then our name or any other name. Let's go close. Okay. Next, we need to configure our mail ID. Means global. Same procedure. We need to give user dot email. Then, as usual, the email ID which we are using. gmail.com. Okay. Now we have configured our mail ID and our username. To view that, let's do the command git config minus user dot name. That is, you can see what name we have given to the user, and then git config user dot email. You can see that our mail ID. By this, we can show our info that who had made the commit and who had changed the file, and reviewed by others that in the software who made the commits and which person and his email ID to know in more detail. Next is that what I have told in remote repository, which I worked earlier. Then further that, let's see how to delete a file in this. Okay, let's move on this. Let's open bash. Now let's go git rm to remove the file, then the file name. Remove the file, then file name, fi. Let's start the tab space so that it auto completed. Now, it's been removed. Now the file.txt is been removed. Let's see the status of the file. Whenever we change or modify, we should view the status of the file. Status. It says that you have deleted that file.txt. Okay. Now let's create another file and make few modifications, few changes. Okay, let's create a new file. Now let's create a Python file, python.py. Okay. Now let's send a small program. Let's print our program. Print. Now let's do a small addition program, and A is equal to 1 comma, B is equal to 3 comma, let's print it. Let's do A plus B. This is the simple program, but to know more and more about Git, we are doing this small program. Okay. So let's open our Git bash and see our status of what has happened in our repository. It says that you have deleted your file.txt. It's in staging area, so it's in green color. Now python.py is not in staging area, but it shows that you have modified and it's untracked. To make everything in track, we need to do git add dot. Let's see git status. Git status, it shows that two files have been modified. Okay. Let's do git commit minus m. Then a small message that what we have done, counter message. Let's go create a new file. New Python file. Okay, it says that now you have entered a message. Now let's view the what are the messages we have committed. Let's click log, which we can see what are the messages, what are the things we have committed. We have made commit, like author Rose, he has committed a message that created a new file, new Python file. And another thing he has done is hello world program, and that's also all committed in this. He has created a new text document. Okay. Now let's move further. These are the staging area what I have told earlier. Now let's see the creating and switching branches. Okay, now let's create a new branch in our project. Let's clear all. Now our project is in master branch. Let's create a new branch, git checkout minus b. Then a branch name, anything we can do. Let's give us develop. Now we have created a branch develop. To see what are all the branches we have, do the command git branch blah. You can see we have created two branches. One is developer branch, another is the master. Master branch is the main branch of the project, and sub branches what we create. Let's create another sub branch, git checkout minus b, and then bug fix. Okay, we have created a new branch called bug fix. If we need to switch from one branch to another, we need to mention git checkout, then the branch name and master. Which we can switch from one branch to another. Now we switch it to master branch. But early we were in bug fix branch. Previous we were in developer branch. Now let's move on to developer branch. Git fail checkout develop. Okay, now we are in developer branch. In developer branch, the changes made in developer branch won't reflect in the main branch. This is the more advantage in Git. Whenever we make changes in developer branch, it will be present only in developer. Whenever we make changes in main branch, it would reflect everywhere. So let's create, let's add a new text document. Text.txt. Okay, we have created a new text document. As you can see, now we have created a text document. New file. Now let's switch from our sub branch to main branch. Let's give git check out master. By this we can know we are in master branch. Okay. This is how we can create a branch, a sub branch by which the main project won't affect to the main branch. Okay, this is how the branch flow works. First the main branch. This is the main branch. First it's in the first version. A few changes are made, it's in the next, second version, then it's in third version, then it's in fourth version, then it's in fifth version. In this between, a new worker or a new developer comes here at the starting stage. He creates a branch, sub branch of his own, and he creates a new branch. He creates few commits and few messages and few changes in few modifications in the project, and then he sends a pull request to the master. Then the master, the main, the owner of the software, would see the changes what he has made by the other developer, and then if he likes or any requirements is equal to his project, or if he need in his project, then he can merge the branches. That is called as merging branches. The pull request given by the request given by the developer to the master is called as pull request. Okay, this is how the branch workflows happen. There are two terminals in work branch working. They are long running branch and one is the topic branch. Long running branch means the main branch, the long run, where the changes made by the main developer. Then next is the topic branch. Topic branch means the developer who contributes to the software and few topics which are made, modified and changed, and it would be added to the main branch. But in this master branch, the changes made throughout the end of the software is called as the long term running branch. Okay, there may be many different types of sub branches. Here one sub branch is there, here one sub branch is there. In future, when a new developer creates another branch, it would be happen here. But the master branch is only branch and single branch. Yeah. Now let's see how to delete a sub branch. Now let's go to git bash. Okay. Now let's see what are the branches present. Git branch. You can see that git branch, upfix, developer and master is present. Okay. Now let's delete a branch. Git branch minus d. The branch name. Which we need to delete. You can delete bugfix or developer branch. Now let's delete bugfix. By which it says that you have deleted a bugfix branch. Okay. Next is off. This is how we delete our branch. Now let's see forking and contributing to our software. This is the main thing in the Git in this webinar. Okay, let's see how to fork others project. Now let's do a real time experiment. Let's create a new folder. Now let's move on to the GitHub. Okay. Now let's search for any project. Let's create it as any project name. Let's move on. Okay. Okay, now let me check my one of my friend's account. Now let's fork it. Once again, this is how we fork it. It says you have already forked because I have done this. Once again, we can take any other account. Okay, let's fork this account. Let's contribute few things to her or his project. to do that, you need to fork. It says that whether you need to fork in this account or this. We can take our own account. Okay, now it's taking a copy of our copy of her project, and it's copying her project from her repository to our own repository, to our own Git repository, remote repository. Now her project is present in our remote repository. Now let's copy this and let's clone it. To do this, let's create another new file with this project 23. Okay, we have created this, and now let's clone the file from the repository. Git clone the file which we want to clone. Then let's click clone. It says that you have successfully cloned. Let's move inside. Let's open the project. She has created a web development folder. Okay, let's make a few changes in this project. Okay, let's go. Different. It's just a small contribution, but it doesn't matter that it's necessary or necessary to her. For trial, we are using this, but in real-time projects, we need to search for what are the bugs or what are the things she need to change to make her project more nice. Okay, let's, now let's save it. Now let's open git bash. Now let's see the status of our project. Is that you don't have any? Sorry, one second. Now we need to open git bash from the terminal where we clone. Okay. Now let's see the git bash and let's see the status of the file. Okay, it says that you have made changes in index.txt. This change would reflect in the main branch, which means the changes made in the main branch, but we should have a practice of creating a new branch and then make a small change. To do this, we open once again a file. Let's create a new branch. Click git checkout -b fixing. Now we have created a new branch fixing. Now let's make few changes in the project. Code dot, we will open our editor. Now let's create any other changes in this project. Okay, let's make changes in the CSS. Let's give the background color as red or any other thing. Okay, let's save it. We are changing this, and let's change the width as, or the width of the container as 50% or any other thing. Let's save it and run once again. Now let's see the git status. Git status. It says that you have made changes in the index.txt and in the style.css. These are the changes which we made in the a small branch. These changes won't be affected in the main branch. To see, let's change the branch. Check out -. By this, we can switch our branch. By this, we can switch to our main branch. Now, let's see, does our change is reflected in our project. But that now the changes is not reflected here. Okay. Okay. Now let's move on to the same fixing branch, git branch. Git branch now. It's git checkout. Now this git checkout can switch branch from one branch to another. FIF fixing git checkout. Now you are in the fixing branch and let's give a commit. Now let's see the status of the file. Git status. Git status, it shows that it shows that you have made the changes, but it's not in the staging area. Let's change all this in the staging area. In the staging area. Now let's see the status of the file. Now you are in the stage area, which says that your project has been tracked and it's in the staging area. To move from our staging area to the committed area, commit minus m, a small message that modification. Modification. It says that we have made the modification in this. Now let's make a pull request. To do this, we go. We need to make pull request from the branching area where we are here. We are in the fixing branch. Fixing is one of the sub branch of the main branch. Okay. Git push origin. Then the branch name fixing. Now it starts pushing from our remote local repository to the remote repository. Let's see the pull request. Okay. Now here we can see that your fixing is a branch. It's a sub branch. Main branch is here. We have created a sub branch. It shows that fixing has a recent push. Now only we have done our pull request. In this message we can give that this is the message that we have created a modification. Let's give you message that more in detail what we have made in this project. Changed the background color. Background color and other changes. Okay. Let's create a pull request. This is how we can make a pull request. And it says that the branch has been not conflict with the basic branch. Conflict means when the changes made in our project and her project have the same thing and differs little bit. At that time, it shows the conflict message that whether you need to keep her changes or our changes, that would be suggested to her and she can see the changes and may fix the changes. This is how we come. Let's see the committed message and then we can see what are the modifications we made in her project. File changes. Then here we can see this is her project. This is our project, what we have made in this. Like this, she can give small suggestions or any message. Whether she can say why you have added this like this message, or she can give the review on your project. This will be given by her, but here I give that why you have added this message and few other things. And here you can see she gave a background color of different, but I gave that it's a red background and I have changed the width as 50%. And these are the two changes which are made by me. And this is how we can view view the changes made by us, and this is the commit message by Mr. Rose. From before 3 minutes he have committed a modification. He has modified the changes made. You can see here the same thing will be reflected to her, and once she see the changes which are made by us, and if she requires these changes to be done in her project also, she can merge with our sub branch. Okay, this is how we can do. Okay, let's before moving here, we can see how to delete a branch. One second, clear. Git branch. We have fixed and the main branch. Now let's move on to main branch. Git account. Checkout, fix, git checkout, main branch. Now we are changed it to main branch. Okay. Now let's delete the branch. To do this, git branch minus d to delete a branch. To delete a branch minus d, then we can do fix or the name or the branch name which we need to delete. Now it says that, sorry, 1 second. And it says that you having merged with your main repository. That means for the first time or when the branch is not merged with the main branch, which means fixing a sub branch is not merged with the main branch which is present here. So it asks a message that whether you need to delete this branch, or else sometimes the developer may by chance he can delete without unknowingly. So let's do git branch minus capital D, then fixing. Now you can delete the branch. It says that you have deleted the branch fixing. Okay, this is how we delete our branch. Okay, let's see the projects which we have made early, which I have made early. Okay, let's go to my repository. In this we can see few other things which I have upscaled. We can see what are the things we have done and what are the issues we have done. We can see the core what we have done. Other things. Okay. Then another thing to know. Everything is okay. Fine. Thank you.
Thank you, Rakesh Roshan. Dear participants, if you have any queries, you can post in chat box. What is the difference between Git and GitHub?
Difference between Git and GitHub. As earlier I have told that Git is a command where we can give the we can track our project and we can make our project tracking, and then we can make changes, and the changes made by us can be reflected in our local repository. To make the changes in the remote repository also, we use Git, and to show the changes and other details, other stuff regarding to that, we use GitHub. It's just a server. And it's the place where every projects are being uploaded. And this is the difference between Git and GitHub. Next. Hello.
Thank you, Rakesh. I request the participants to fill the feedback form that is posted in the Mr. Sampath Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer, to give away the work.
Okay. First of all, I thank Bhavya Shri for supporting us to organize this wonderful webinar session. Thank you, Bhavya Shri. Next, I would like to thank Rakesh Roshan for delivering such a wonderful webinar on version control system using JIT. Okay, students, next we are going to meet again on July 17th. On July 17th, we have another wonderful webinar on machine learning by Mr. Bhuvanesh and Adishwara, both belong to third year CSE. Next, I would like to invite Ms. Saranya ma'am from Department of Computer Science and Engineering to deliver a vote of thanks.
I take this opportunity to appreciate Mr. Rakesh Roshan for his mind-blowing session in the way of his kindness to help our student friends to understand the version control using Git from the beginning to the end of the session. He have also given the hands-on session on each and every controls which is used in our Git website. I wholeheartedly thank our management team, Department of CSE, for giving us a wonderful opportunity to conduct such a wonderful student webinar series session for our students to transfer their knowledge to other students and make other students get inspired from our student speakers. I once again thank you all for your active participation. I would require the same support from all of you for the upcoming weeks. Every week Saturday, we have this student webinar series with lot of interesting topics through students which will get benefited to everyone. Thank you all.
அன்பு கிடைத்தது, பண்பு கிடைத்தது, நட்பு கிடைத்தது, கனவு கிடைத்தது நம்மீஸ்வர் கல்லூரி. இங்கேதான் தெளிவு கிடைத்தது, அறிவு கிடைத்தது, அறமும் கிடைத்தது, அனைத்தும் கிடைத்தது நம்மீஸ்வர் கல்லூரி. பசுமை வண்ணம் கொண்ட சூழலிலே மயில்கள் கொண்ட எம் கல்லூரியே, ஒற்றுமைக்கும் உத்வேகம் ஆசிரியர்கள் எல்லோரும் வெற்றிகளில் அஸ்திவாரம். ஆதவன் இல்லாமல் விடியல் ஏது, பாதைகள் இல்லாமல் பயணம் ஏது, கேள்விகள் இல்லாமல் விடைகள் ஏது, ஈஸ்வர் கல்லூரி இல்லாமல் இன்பம் ஏது. சென்டர் ஓப்பனர் தியேட்டர், அங்கே உலகம் கற்றுக்கொள்வோமே. நம் காலேஜின் பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் அது என்றும் சூப்பர், அங்கே வேலையும் பெற்றுக்கொள்வோமே. நான்காண்டுகளே என்றாலும் ஒரு குடும்பம் போல வாழ்ந்திடுவோம். 40 ஆண்டுகள் கடந்த பின்னும் நம் கல்லூரி நாட்களை போற்றிடுவோம். இந்த நிலையை நாங்கள் அடைந்தாலும் வாழ்வில் உயர பறந்தாலும் மறவோம் மறவோம் ஒரு நாளும் நாங்கள் ஈஸ்வரில் பயின்ற நாட்களை. ஈஸ்வர் கல்லூரி வாழ்க்கை கற்று தந்த பாடம், காலம் எல்லாம்